How into racing are you? I'm not much of a racer, but I'm wondering if this is part of the world, or you just began to learn it to get into the role here.
You're from New York. You're from New York, correct? You were born, right? I mean, so like I grew up. It was very odd though because I was a Richard Petty fan.
Yes.
So that must have been. I remember drawing number 43 like on a car on my notebook.
Yes.
And I in school, and I one year I went as Halloween as I went as Richard Petty. I had the cowboy hat, the glasses, and a mustache, and I had a steering wheel with me, and nobody knew who I was. But tell me, I must have seen that on Wide World of Sports. How would I know about NASCAR on Long Island?
That's a great question, because I'm from Staten Island, and yes, the left turns were only the ones you make from the right lane. That's the way I grew up. That's the way I grew up knowing about left turns. You make them whenever the hell you damn please, no matter what lane
you're in. Exactly. Knew nothing about it until... I guess about 12 years ago or something like that, me and Sandler had to go do press for a movie, and we had to do the Gentlemen Start Your Engines. We were asked to do that, and I was asked to be a Grand Marshal at a couple races, and it blew my mind.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the craziest sport I've ever seen. It's a whole new world. I mean, I didn't know. I just knowing on TV, you know, you see it on TV, you just think it's guys going in circles and it's just the guy in front's going to win, I guess.
Hey.
But it's just the whole world.
Listen, Kevin, I went to college at Michigan, so I've seen games in the big house, but nothing compares when you show up to the Texas Motor Speedway and the whole place is packed and the place is going absolutely crazy and you know, gentlemen, start your engines, you said, or you know, off you go, and nothing's been... there really is not, obviously, you know, pre-pandemic, the power of being at a NASCAR live, a NASCAR race and event. It's amazing. There's really nothing you can compare it to, for real.
There's nothing. And even the tailgate, you know, other sports you tailgate outside.
Right.
Tailgating is on the infield. They brought it in. It's on the infield. If the race is going around the tailgate, there are people that are on their RVs literally saying, I'll watch a race, but as long as it's around, like, I'm not getting off the roof of my RV. That's what I'm not doing. And the fans were fantastic. It was amazing. It's just, and these guys are athletes. I didn't know that either. That's the other thing.
Yeah, I mean, there is a certain intensity that comes with swapping paint and making sure that you're winning, and you're also controlling this machine that's going so fast. I agree with you. It's pretty cool that you're exposed to this. So tell me about the show. Like, what's the construct of the show that people should know about, Kevin?
Well, I play a crew chief, and it's basically we have a team that's was more competitive a little while ago. We've kind of lost. I was an ex-racer, and I retired. And my boss gave me a job as a crew chief of this team, and we've done well, but we've lost a few, lost a step recently, and he's actually bringing his daughter in to kind of run it now and kind of take over. So it's a little bit of the out with the old and in with the new, and he wants to keep me. So it's just that battle of new technology coming in and you know, trying to stick with the old ways that things worked in the past, and you know, tradition, and I'm trying to say it's gut feeling. Everything can't be solved on a computer, and you know, but that is the game. That is what's happening in NASCAR, man. A lot of this stuff is just, you know, these computer guys are coming out and taking over. You know,
just in time for the Daytona 500. You know, when we've been going back and forth with NASCAR about talking to the winner of the Daytona 500, and you know, they saw you were on the show. They said, "Say hi." Literally, this is what they said. So you're connected clearly with NASCAR for the show, right?
Yeah, they sent some guys. We you know, NASCAR, that was the biggest deal. You don't want to be working for a Schmascar show. You know, it had to be everything NASCAR. They were all in on it, and they've never done a show before, so I was excited about that. And they sent us cars. They sent us everything. We've had drivers. We had Ryan Blaney, man. I'll tell you, Cole Custer. We had Austin Dillon. And these guys were hilarious. Blaney was amazing. I couldn't believe how funny he was. It actually pissed me off because it was like, I thought I'd be able to school him in something, and he came on and it was in front of a live audience too. You know, it was before the shutdown, and he's got a funny way about him, man. He's just dry. He's just a great. He can deliver a joke. And again, it pissed me off.
I know. You got to tell these guys to stay in their lane, like figuratively, Kevin. You know what I mean?
Exactly. It's true.
What are they doing?
True. I didn't. Yeah.
What are they doing? You shouldn't be swapping paint with you in a comedy lane. I mean, that's
I know,
that's
it's
absurd.
That competitive attitude.
Who the hell do they think they are? Did you do a ride along? Did you do a ride or get behind a wheel yourself?
I met a guy, Tony Gibson, who was a crew chief, and he's amazing. He took me around and showed me a couple of races and stuff. And I've gotten in a pace car before. I don't like speed. I don't like it that much. I don't like being in there. I like watching it. Especially when unless I'm driving, but even then, I don't want to be out there with anybody else.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.